you, gorgeous souls. Welcome to another day on our journey of a year of yoga as we bring our hands to our heart center, setting an intention for the day. What would you love to get out of your practice today? Placing our hands on the mat beside us, dropping our right ear to the right shoulder or left ear to the left shoulder, and walking the opposite hand away from the body, over to the other side. Coming back to the middle. Chin to chest, dropping the head forward. Back to the center and then dropping the head back, stretching out through the throat and the front of the neck. And just circling the head now in whatever way or capacity feels good for you. Maybe circling one way, back the other way, or maybe nodding or shaking your head side to side. Maybe taking your nose towards the armpit and then back to the middle, interlacing the fingers, turning the hands inside out, raising our arms above our head, stretching as far as we can, bringing the arms back down by our side, interlacing the fingers, palms facing the head this time. Stretching the shoulders as we pull the shoulder blades away from the body. And then interlacing the fingers behind the back. Dropping the head back if you like, raising the arms as far as they will go. It is a very arm-focused praxis today as we bring our left arm across our body. Right arm is pulling the left arm in towards the chest. And then over to the right arm as the left arm pulls it inwards. Stretching the triceps now. Right arm pushing the left elbow down the back. And then left hand pushing the right elbow down the back. Inhaling, then exhaling as we lean over to the right, getting a side bend as the left arm comes up overhead. And then over to the left side as we bring the right arm up overhead. Inhaling as we rise and exhaling as we bend. And then opening the chest a little more towards the heavens on both sides, just tilting that elbow back slightly to expose the chest to the sky. Back to center. Bringing the legs into butterfly pose and then grabbing the feet with the hands, pulling the shoulders away from the ears, sitting nice and tall, seeing if you can gently guide the knees towards the earth. And continuing to breathe deeply. Taking the left leg long now, tucking the right foot in towards the pelvis. Big deep breath in, and on the exhale, running the left hand down the right leg. And then the right arm is going to come up and over the head so that we get this beautiful stretch through the side of the body as well as the hamstring and the back of the left leg. And reaching for the toes if you can make it. If you can't make it, that's okay. Just go as far as you can. And if this is too painful, you might find that you're a little bit tight. You can bring the right hand over onto the left arm and just drop the head between the shoulders, between the arms. Changing sides, tucking the left foot in towards the pelvis, right leg long. And on the exhale, sliding the right hand down the right leg, left arm comes up overhead. Again, feeling that side bend, that side stretch. Trying to make it to the toes if you can. And again, you can stay here, getting the side bend and back of the leg stretched, or you can drop the head between the arms, bringing the left arm onto the right. Just hugging the knees in now in a seated position. Gently resting your chin on the knees. Curling up into a ball. And then placing the hands behind the hips. We just want to lift the bottom off the mat here. Just hover it above the earth and just releasing any tension that's along the spine from the compression of sitting. Maybe drawing some figure eights with your bottom or swaying side to side, front and back, circles. Hopefully, it feels nice to have that tension released on the spine. And then coming over into tabletop position. I'm just going to work the scapula here. So just turning the hands to face the knees first as we stretch the forearms. Just leaning back. You might want to lean slightly side to side or shifting the body weight forward and backward. Just getting a beautiful stretch through the forearms. And moving in whatever way feels good for you. And then as we turn our hands around, I'm just going to work the scapula, as I said, so dropping the chest towards the floor, but keeping the arms in the same position. So lowering the upper body and then lifting. So we're getting a stretch through the back of the shoulder and the upper back. Maintaining the straight arms here. And then coming into cat cow, we're going to do three cat cows, dropping the head back, chest and abs towards the floor, and then exhaling through to cat pose as we curve the spine towards the ceiling. Inhaling into cow, exhaling into cat. One more time. Cow pose. Transitioning into cat pose. Back to neutral spine. Tucking the toes and just hovering the knees above the mat so we maintain the integrity through the spine. Engaging the core here. My legs probably should have been a little bit closer. See how they're not quite 90 degrees? So try and get 90 degrees there. And then pushing back into downward facing dog, pedaling out the legs if that feels good, pushing the heels towards the earth. And making sure the shoulders are pushed away from the ears. Hips are high. I felt really tight with this one today. And then coming into dolphin pose, keeping the hips high, coming down onto the forearms. Breathing. And if you're feeling dizzy at all or lightheaded, just come out of this pose and go into child's pose. Coming back up onto our arms into downward dog and then high plank. We're just going to tap the outside of each hand. So taking the right hand to the outside of the left hand to the outside of the right. Just five times each side. Engaging the core and the glutes. Maintaining that nice straight line. And then slowly lowering the body to the mat. Untucking the toes, three baby cobras. And then we're going to grab each foot with the hand on each side and just give the quadriceps a stretch here. So pulling the heels towards the bottom. I don't know about you, but I felt a really deep stretch through the front of the legs here. And then pulling the arms and the feet away from each other, raising the legs and the chest off the floor into bow pose, and then gently releasing the feet and the arms back to the floor. Coming into a low plank now, so coming up onto the forearms and onto the toes. Continuing to breathe, you don't want to hold your breath in this pose as we come back into downward facing dog. Coming into high plank and do some shoulder taps this time, so five each side. And then slowly lowering the body to the floor. Untucking the toes, three baby cobras. And then we're going to grab the feet with the hands and stretch out the quads again. Taking some deep breaths. And then pulling the hands and the feet away from each other, lifting the chest and the legs off the mat. Bow pose. Gently releasing. Coming into a low plank. And you can see that my posture is not great here, so my neck is scooped. It should be a little bit higher. I've got a bit of a bend between my neck coming over my shoulders. So just check your posture and try and get that line nice and straight. Downward facing dog. Dolphin. Remembering to breathe. then gently releasing the knees to the mat, coming into child's pose, legs together, arms running down by our sides, and our forehead is gently resting on the mat. Taking one more deep breath in. And exhaling. Nice and slowly before gently rising. And then coming straight into a side plank, pressing down through the right hand, left arm high, hips are high. And we're up on the side of our feet. And then we're going to turn and come straight onto a reverse plank. So palms are facing down, wrists are underneath our shoulders, legs are straight, we're up on our heels. And our gaze is slightly up and back. And then if we can, we're going to roll over to the side without touching our bottom on the mat, coming into a side plank on the left side, planting down through the left hand. Hips are high, engaging the glutes and the abdominals here. And then gently releasing as we bring our bottom to the mat. Maybe doing it a little bit more gracefully than what I did. Tucking the knees in towards the chest now. We're starting to slow down our practice as we take both knees over to the right side of the body, taking our gaze over to the left. You might get a couple of cracks along the spine. Feeling a stretch or a twist through the muscles in the lower part of the back. And then gently raising the knees to the middle as we lean over to the left side, taking our gaze over to the right. Back to center. Gently placing the soles of the feet on the outside of the mat and letting the knees fall into touch in the middle. And just letting them lean against one another while our back is completely flat on the mat. And we start to feel our heart rate slow. And you can stay in this position, or if you like, you can stretch the legs out into savasana. But it felt good for me just to have the legs bent today. And palms can be face up or face down, whatever you're feeling. And just letting it all go. Releasing anything that's not serving you right now for the highest good. That could be worry, fear, stress, doubt, uncertainty. It's just not serving your higher power right now. And they are low vibrational states. So when we leave the mat today, how can we find those higher vibrational states? Of blissfulness, joy, ecstasy, excitement, happiness. You're finding that thoughts continue to crowd your mind rather than trying to stop them. Bring them into your awareness. Acknowledge them. And then just move them along. Especially if they're thoughts around things that you need to do, or where you should be, or who you should be. Because we don't have to be anything, we don't have to do anything, we don't have to want for anything. This is our time. To allow the peace and serenity to flow into our daily life. So be proud and be happy of the decision you made to get on the mat today. May not seem like a big deal, but it is. You should celebrate and honor yourself for that. Starting to bring some movement into the body. Let's give yourself a big cuddle, wrapping the arms around. Just feeling the love that you have for yourself. And if it's lacking, then sending yourself some love today. As we gently roll over to one side. And then when you're ready, pushing up into the seated pose position as we round out this practice. Sitting nice and tall, feeling nice and relaxed, and taking a big breath in as we bring our arms overhead, palms together at our third eye. May we have kind and loving thoughts today. As we lower them to our lips, may we speak kind and loving words today. As we lower them to our heart, may we have kind and loving intentions today. Have a beautiful day, everyone. Namaste.